Was that here? Yes. Abdul Wali is not here?
No, he's here.
Okay. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله على النبي الكريم محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين. The next one is Angel of Womb. As Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said in a hadith, you should refer to يجمع أحدكم في بطن أمه 40 يوما نطفة. One of you remains there in the womb of his mother for 40 days as نطفة. ثم تكون علقة مثل ذلك. Then he is in shape of علقة, clot or leech for another 40 days. ثم تكون مضغة مثل ذلك. Then he is in shape of a piece of meat or like a gum for another 40 days. ثم يرسل الله إليه الملك. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after 120 days, he sends an angel. فينفخ فيه. And he blows the spirit and soul there in that body. Got it? So this is another duty. Angel of womb. And she is not one. Once again, that's a big army. Got it? The next one. Karrubiyin. Karrubiyin. These are angels holding the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also they are called the Hamalatul Harsh. حملت العرش سورة الحاقة chapter
69
ويحمل عرش ربك فوقهم يومئذ ثمانية
آية 17
ويحمل عرش ربك فوقهم يومئذ ثمانية. On that very day, eight ranks of angels, not eight angels, eight rows of angels. Allah knows how many angels are there in one row. Eight rows of angels, they will be holding the harsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Got it? And the next one. An-Nasi'u wal-Munkar. Again, a big army. Two of them come to every dead one after his burial or as the case may be. You should write it down. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Iza ukbir al-mayyit." When the dead body is taken to its resting place or rest place, أَتَاهُ مَلَكَانِ أَسْوَدَانِ أَزْرَقَانِ. There come to him two angels with black complexion and blue eyes. Black complexion and blue eyes. And that is a frightening shape. Yes. Blue eyes with white complexion, that's a beauty. but blue eyes with the very dark complexion. Yes. فَأَتَاهُ مَلَكَانِ أَسْوَدَانِ أَزْرَقَانِ. رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم said, فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ. And they both ask the person concerned, مَرْ رَبُّكَ. Who is your Lord? وَمَا دِينُكَ. And what is your deen? وَمَا تَقُولُ فِي هَذَا الرَّجُلِ الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ. And what do you say concerning this person who has been sent to you? The image is shown to him. The image of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is shown to the dead one. That what do you say about this person who was sent to you people? If he is a practical Muslim, so he will say, Rabbi Allah, my Lord is Allah. وديني الإسلام, my deen is Islam. وهذا نبي الله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, and this is the messenger of Allah, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. If the case is otherwise, so for every single question the person concerned will say, ha ha la adri, oh I don't know, got it? So these angels are called النكير والمنكر. The next group angels of paradise, two groups. One, those who will take him to Jannah. And the other one, a group who will salute him at the entrance. Then the chief of Jannah, he is called Ridwan from Malaysia. He is called Ridwan. He is the chief of angels in paradise. Surah Az-Zumar. Chapter? The last ayah. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْ رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا. Ayah number?
Ayah number
73. وثيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا. And those who had the fear of their Lord, they would be taken to Jannah. زمرا in groups. زمرا in groups. حتى إذا جاءوها. Then when they come to the entrance of Jannah. وقال لهم خزنتها. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the very beginning said, وثيق would be taken. By whom? By the angels. This is this group. Yes. حتى إذا جاءوها. When they will come to the entrance. وقال لهم خزنتها. The God angels at the entrance of paradise. They will say, سلام عليكم. Yes. Look at me. سلام عليكم. Salutation. Yes. They will salute to him. God got it? Yes. Then the angels of hellfire, they are also two groups. one those who will take them to the hell. Allah forgive and forbid. And the second one, those who will blame them at the entrance the same surah Zumar وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا Understand? Don't be sleeping. Very active. Yes. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ زُمَرًا حَتَّى ayah number 71 chapter
73. chapter 39
ayah number 71 وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ زُمَرًا and those who disbelieved they would be taken to the hellfire in groups حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا then when they come there فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا so they will open the gate the angel وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا again the second group the God angel they will say to them أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ have you not received the messengers of Allah what's wrong with you people why you people are here what was wrong with you why you did not listen to the messengers have you not received the messengers أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ وَيُنذِرُونَكُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا Have you not received the messengers of your Lord who are reciting to you the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and giving you warning about this very day? Have you not received them? قَالُوا بَلَا They will say, of course we did receive. وَلَكِنْ حَقَّ كَلِمَةُ الْعَذَابِ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ But we are disbelievers and for disbelievers there is a decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and take the punishment. Got it? Got or not? And then, a third group is there. As he said, Rizwan. Yes? That he is inside the Jannah. So a third group, and their chief is called Malik. And under him, there are 19 superintendents. How many?
19.
Why not 18 or 20? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this figure is unfair test. Yes, let people to be confused. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا أَصْحَابَ النَّارِ إِلَّا مَلَائِكَ وَمَا جَعَلْنَا عِدَّةً إِلَّا فِتْنَةً لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا Surah Al-Muddathir.
Surah number
74, 31. No, before that, yes. Here. Ayah number? Ayah 30. And chapter?
74.
74. Aleha tisata hajar. Over the hellfire there are 19 angels. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا أَصْحَابَ النَّارِ إِلَّا مَلَائِكَ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, We have not appointed the custodians of hellfire but angels. But who? Angels. Because if they would have a human being, they would be looking towards bride. Yes. To give a comfort to those who will be in jail. As it's going on in jail, especially in Pakistan. India are in third world. Yes. Those who are in prison, they are feeding the jailer. Yes. And the police dear. He's Nambardar then. He's what? He's called Nambardar. Yes. And if not, yes, he is beaten inside jail. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا أَصْحَابَ النَّارِ Now the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do not have any desire. So that's why. Nobody can expect any comfort therefrom. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا أَصْحَابَ النَّارِ إِلَّا مَلَائِكَ That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to. That we have not appointed the custodians of the hellfire but angels. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا عِدَّتَهُمْ إِلَّا فِتْنَةً لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا And we have not fixed that their number is 19, but a test and trial for disbelievers. So let them be confused. And they had been asking Rasulullah, why are you banking? Why not 20? And why not 80? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Prophet, yes, let them to be confused in this number. وَمَا جَهَلْنَا أَصْحَابَ النَّارِ إِلَّا مَلَائِكَ وَمَا جَهَلْنَا هَجَّتَهُمْ إِلَّا فِتَّةً لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. And also in Surah Al-Tahrim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says regarding these 19, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا. Chapter Tahrim. Yes, Tahrim. Yes, the last surah of Juz 28. Before Surah Mulk. Chapter? And ayah 6. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you who believe, who anfusakum, protect yourself. Wa alaykum and your family, naran, from blazing fire. Aleha malaikatun ghiladun shidad. Aleha malaikatun, upon or over that hellfire there are angels. Ghiladun, very rude. Ghiladun, very rude in nature. Shidadun, and very tough in seizing or in catching. Yes. Ghiladun, shidad. So they don't speak to people. Yes, nicely, no? Because forces not to speak to people nicely. If they will say, yes, sir, so you have killed this guy. Oh, thank you very much. It's not me. Yes, you have killed it. Yes, you did it. عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. They do not disobey whatever they have been ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they do whatever they have been ordered by Allah. So can you tell me how many categories of angels? 13. And there are a lot more. But these are some of the categories which are mentioned here either in ayat or in a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hadith number 15. Again, Abu Huraira. The encyclopedia of hadith. He was not a person. He was an encyclopedia. 5,374 hadith. These are narrated from Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala an. 5,374. Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala an. And hadith is narrated by Bukhari, Muslim, Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the hadith is read like this. يقول الله تعالى أنا عند ظن عبدي بي وأنا معه إذا ذكرني فإن ذكرني في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي وإن ذكرني في ملأ ذكرته في ملأ خير منه وإن تقرب إلي بشبر تقربت إليه ذراعا وإن تقرب إلي ذراعا تقربت إليه باعا وإن أتاني يمشي أتيته هرولة. رواه البخاري. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, write it down. I am as my servant thinks I am. Or another meaning of the same sentence, I am as my servant expects me to be. The first meaning of the jumla of sentence is, I am, as my servant thinks me I am, or as my servant expects me to be. I am with him. When he remembers me, or mentions me, So if he makes the mention of me to himself alone, I make mention of him to myself. And if he makes mention of me in an assembly of people, in a gathering, I make mention of him in an assembly better than of his assembly, and if he draws near to me a hand's span, I draw near to him, I draw near to him an arm's length. This is. He draws near to me that much, I come close to him that much. And if he draws near to me an arm's length, so look at me, I draw near to him a fathom's length, F-A-T-H-O-M. Fathom, that's two hands. And if he comes to me walking, fathom, F-A-T-H-O-M. And if he comes to me walking, I come to him at speed or running. Because running is like this, look, but speed is something else. You know what I'm saying? Speed is much more than running. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used the word harwalatan. Look, when the horse is running, yes. Have you ever have ride a sangha, horse cart in Karachi? You did not? Yes. So, normally it goes like this. Yes? So this is running. This is what? Running. But speed is. Both. Yes. What they got? Yes, gallop. So you should like it. Got it or not it? Interpretation of hadith. One, who starts going towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in love with him, coming towards him, much more than what he has done. Or what he has what? Point number two, which is the interpretation of this point, going towards Allah means worshipping. Surah Al-Ma'idah. حافظان صاحبان فائند اوڈ آیا یا ایو الذین آمنوا اتقوا اللہ وابتغوا الیہ الوسیلہ وجاہدوا فی سبیلہ لعلکم تفلحون. Slowly, don't be panic. Otherwise, you will miss Surah Al-Ma'idah as a whole. Not only the ayah. All you who believe, fear Allah. Number one. All you who believe, fear Allah. And seek means of going close to Allah. And seek means of going close to Allah. And strive hard in the path of Allah. In order to get into success. So means of going close to Allah. It means worship is taught by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nobody may invent his own way of worship. If somebody will invent and create his own way of worship, it will not take him close to Allah, it will take him far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will be going on reverse. So going close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way is how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did it. Got it? Going close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the purpose of life. What's the purpose of human life? To get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to follow the footsteps of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Taking the way to go close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why a person becomes Muslim by saying, La ilaha illallah. Muhammadur Rasulullah. Two sentences. So this is the purpose of life. This one. La ilaha illallah. This is the purpose of life. And this is the way of life. The first one is the purpose of life. And the second one, the way of life. So the purpose of life is ittaqullah, fear Allah. Ittaqullah. Got it? And the way of life, wabtaghu ilayhi alwasila. Got it? Ittaqullah, la ilaha illallah. Wabtaghu ilayhi alwasila. Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Got it, not it? Surah Al-Imran. In kuntum tuhibbun Allah, fattabi'uni. Yuhibbukum Allah wa yaghfir lakum dhunubakum wallahu ghafurur rahim. 31 chapter 3 قل سيء محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم إن كنتم تحبون الله if you people love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or you want to be in love with Allah you want to be in love if you want to be in love with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so tell them فاتبعوني emulate me فاتبعوني emulate me copy me فاتبعوني copy me emulate me the proper word is emulate because copy is not that good yeah there are three words number one imitate number two copy number three emulate imitate is totally in a wrong way copy sometime in good way and sometime in bad way and emulate that's in good way only got it so فاتبعوني يحببكم الله emulate me Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be in love with you. You should write it. If you are trying to be in love with Allah, if you will emulate Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be in love with you. Got it? Yes, and when Allah is in love with someone, وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ That's the result or the after effect or the ultimate result. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ He will forgive your sins. He will forgive your sins. Because if somebody is numb with someone, so his mistake or his crime even, or his violation is not looking a crime to him. Because he is his beloved. So when you will become the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your violation would not be considered as a violation. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ And that's why. Yes, that's a matter of belief that all Sahaba of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, they were the beloved of Allah. Because they were emulating Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Sahaba, they were not obeying Rasulullah. They were emulating Rasulullah. Obey means something which you are bound to do. Pray. Yes, that's obedience. That's what? Obedience. Fast. That's what? That obedience. But sit like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Eat like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dress like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Speak like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know what I'm saying? Sleep like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Have your shape like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's called emulation. That's called what? Emulation. And that's something very logical and reasonable. If you are in love with someone. You know what I'm saying? Yes? And you saw someone from far that he is walking like your beloved. So you are staring at him. Oh, you are walking like my friend. You know what I'm saying? Why you fell in love with that guy? Are you like him? Because he is look like your friend. He's what? Look like your friend. So if somebody will emulate Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so it means that he is look like the friend of Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes or no? Qurin kuntum tuhibbun Allah. So anybody who is from far walking like Hafiz Sahib, so Fahim is in love with. Yes. That oh, he was walking like Hafiz Sahib. I thought that yes, Hafiz Sahib. I haven't seen him for the last 3 days. You know what I'm saying? Yes or no? But you have some doubt about this? Okay. Fahim? I think he does not believe that. What about you? Am I right? What I say about you? So anyhow, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ Another important point regarding this. That concerning Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there are two things. Number one, obedience to the Prophet. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And number two, to emulate. tribulation. Obedience in ibadat. That is what? In ibadat or worship. And emulate is in adat. Habits. Manners. Got it? Behave. Got it? Now this one, obedience, it will take you to Jannah. If you will obey Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it will take you where? To Jannah. And if you will emulate Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it will make you a friend of Allah. So you want to be in Jannah only or to be a friend of Allah? Yes. So for the third purpose, you have to emulate Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes. Just ask ulama, how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was having his hair up head. Yes, how he had his beard. How he was dressing. How he was sitting. How he was sleeping. How he was drinking. How he was eating. Yes, you can eat anyway. All people are eating. Yes, the Americans, they eat a lot. Not a little. But they eat their way. Yes or not? Yes, and we do eat. But as a Muslim, we have to eat like human. And where from we will be taking the humanity? Our humanitarian naam? From Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was giving the same training to his sahaba. Ridwanullahi alayhi wa jma'in. Sayyidina Anas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu says, that once I was sitting with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and I was eating this. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told me, Ya Bunayya, sammillah. Ya Bunayya, O my son, sammillah. Start in the name of Allah. Bismillah. Got it? وَكُلْ بِيَمِينِكَ. Eat with your right hand. Eat with... Because the left hand is used in bathroom. Yes. And as you know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by nature, he was nafis. Yes. He was in love with cleanliness. So eat with your... Yes. If somebody is washing his private part with the same hand and eating with the same hand, then he will think for a while. The same hand. Got it? So that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, وَكُلْ بِيَمِينِكَ. Eat with your right hand. وَكُلْ مِمَّا يَدِيكَ. And if you are eating from a common plate, so Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that don't jump in front of another one. Yes, just eat from your side. You understand? Because if you are jumping in front of somebody else, maybe he doesn't like it. Yes. Number one. And number two, it will degrade your personality as well. Yes. That's what an uncultured man. Yes, I am. Because just also uncultured to do like this, but what can I say? My nostrils are swelling. So, وَكُلْ بِيَمِينِكَ وَكُلْ مِمَّا يَلِي. Now look, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when you are so if you are doing the same in front of people, you open your mouth. How bad it's looking, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says. Yes. Number one, so you may not look bad. And number two, you may not pass over your own virus and bacteria to others as well. That's a medical way. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says. Got it? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when you are sitting, yes. If you are sitting in front of someone, yes, I am passing word for free. Yes, not charging you for any virus or bacteria. That's looking good? You know what I'm saying? So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was giving that training to his sahaba, Ridwanullahi alayhi wa jma'in. To Hikaj ibn Zubayr, radiyallahu ta'ala, another sahabi, Imam Tirmidhi, narrated in Kitabul Athaima, a hadith, Hikaj ibn Zubayr, radiyallahu ta'ala, he says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told me, there, subhanAllah, in the book of the hadith, there is a specific chapter in every book, And that is Abwabul Adab. But Abwabul Adab, manners. Abwabul Adab. Because human beings are to be known through what? Manners. Morality. Ethics. Character. Behalf. You know what I'm saying? Got it? So Abwabul Adab, that how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, now look, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, that even though if you are inside a room alone, alone and alone, and you are going to change. Got it? So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, don't make yourself totally naked. Have some haya from those angels who are accompanying you. We don't think so. Yes, nobody is here. Just your life. Yes. Total naked. Like a newborn baby. It's not looking good. Now do it as if somebody is here. And you want not to be seen to him. You know what I'm saying? Rasulullah, these are manners. These are what? These are manners. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Sahabi, if this button was open, like this. You know what I'm saying? So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if this is not needed, why you have put it? And if that is needed, so why you haven't tied it? It's not looking good. Yes? Shoes, if you will put it like this, one after the other, it's not looking good. Prophet used to put it like this. Yes. And, just subhanAllah, I shouldn't say, but I should. Yes. Yes. A Muslim is to be known through what? Manner. So if you are putting your shoes here on the carpet, while the shoe rack is here, the manner is to put your shoes where? Sure. In the shoe rack. And you are not putting it. It's against manner. What type of Muslim you are? You don't know the manner. Yes. The parking places are there. If you are parking here, with the fine line. What type of Muslim you are? You don't know the manner? You know what I'm saying? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, subhanAllah. Sometimes, for example, yes, Hamza, he brings his car. Yes. And we are going somewhere. BMW. Yes. And everybody wants to sit in the front seat. That's a prestige or something like that. To sit in the front seat. Yes? Or to drive their car. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yes, he said only one single sentence and make the life easy. He said, Sahibu Dabati, Awla aw ahakku birasiha. The front seat, that is the due right of the owner. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, front seat, that is the due right of the owner. At that time the ride was horse. So who will sit in the front and who will be behind him? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the owner, he will be in the front. And the second one? Yeah, the lifted one. Who? The lifted one. He will be in the back. So the same rule would be applied here. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if you are in a place where you want to perform your salat with jama'ah, in the house of Fahim, to perform your prayer with jama'ah, I am there. Pakistan is here. Brother Abdul Wali is here. Two, three other ulama are here. Yes. Now Fahim is confused. That whom should I ask to lead the prayer? Because there's also a matter of prestige for ulama. That look, he asked that Maulvi sir to lead the prayer and not me. It means he degraded me. It means he degraded me. And he gave a due respect to that Maulvi sir. You know what I'm saying? For example, so Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there in the house of someone, the owner has the right to lead the prayer. Got it? Now that is his due right. He can do it. If he doesn't, so that is his due right to ask someone from his guest that you should lead the prayer. These are manners. These are manners. How to be helped. How to help. Away us. Our life. So two things are there. Obedience to the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's in ibadat. To emulate the Prophet, that's in Adat. That's what? In Adat. In Ibadat, if you will obey the Messenger, you will get into Jannah. In Adat, if you will emulate the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will be in love with Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will love you. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. The ultimate result is, He will forgive your sins. He will forgive your sins. And then Allah, you should write it. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in love with someone, The hadith is there. It's coming, I think. That when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves someone, he says to Jibreel, Da'a Jibreel, he calls Jibreel, come on. So he goes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him, Jibreel, I love Mr. So and so. Fahibbahu, you may love him. Jibreel says, of course. And you love someone, I do love him. Your friend is mine. And then Jibreel announced the same love in all the seven heavens to the angels, zillions and trillions of angels, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in love with Mr. So and so. And I'm in love with, and you may love him. So all the angels said, yes, we are in love with. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that the same visitors of angels, what? The rest are visitors of angels. They are coming down to the earth, and they are putting the love of that person in the hearts of believers. You should write it. And then people love him for the sake of Allah. Then people love him. What? For the sake of Allah. Have you ever heard that Mawlana Ilyas Sahab Rahmatullah Alayh, he was distributing money amongst people in Mewat? Have you ever heard? He was not in Nawab. He was not a king distributing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves him. People are in love with him after his death even. Yes or not? So when we mention his name, we say Mawlana Ilyas Sahab Rahmatullah Alayh. Yes, Shaykhul Aziz Sahab, Rahmatullahi Alayh. Do you know what I'm saying? Or for example, why we are, look at me, why when Hafiz Sahab comes, so we spend. Otherwise, people are not sending to their own parents. You know what I'm saying? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves him, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put that love in the hearts of others. And supported by ayah of Surah Maryam. إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات سيجعل لهم الرحمن ودا. That's in the end of Maryam.
Surah 94.
Why? I told you, don't be panic. Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala says, to be panic in pain and worse than pain. To be panic in pain, and you are not in pain and you become panic. You are in birth. Birth is not a pain. Yes? So that's why, ajala, or to make hurry, or to do haste, that is not appreciated. You know what I'm saying? Because then your brain does not work. Your neural system, it is shrunk. When you become panicked, so your neural system becomes what? And you lose all of your qualities. Your brain, your memory, your hippos. Yes, when somebody becomes panicked, he can. Otherwise, he can run like a horse, but then his neural system does not support it, so he falls down. You know that thing? So that's why Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala says, to be panicked in pain is worse than pain. Yes, what a man he was. What a beautiful sentence he said. To be panic and pain is worse than pain. Ashad ibn Abdul Qais. Who? Remember this name. Ashad ibn Abdul Qais. He was the chief of his own tribe. He came in a delegation to meet Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was not Muslim at that time. Ashad ibn Abdul Qais. Radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He came, yes, as a delegation to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Medina. And when he started talking to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the way he was talking, very calm, very quiet, slowly, yes, listening to others and having his own speech, very calm and quiet. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before his iman even, he said to him, Ya ashadju, inna fika la khaslatan, yuhibbuhum Allah. Al-Hilm wal-Ana'a. That you have two very, very, very beautiful qualities. You have been blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by two qualities. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves these two qualities. Al-Hilm wal-Ana'a. Clemency, calm and quiet. No emotion. What? We jump. We, and this jumping, it creates troubles. which create problem.
Yes, no.
Yes. And that's what I say, that Muslims in excitement, they become emotional rather than to be sensible. Excitement is okay.
Excitement
is okay, but emotionalism is not okay. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, لِكُلِّ شِئٍ شِرَةٌ وَلِكُلِّ شِرَةٍ فَطْرَةٌ فَإِنْ صَدَّرَ وَقَارَفْ فَرْجُوا مِنْهُ وَإِنْ أُشِيرَ إِلَيْهِ بِالْأَصَابِعِ فَلَا تَعُدُّهُ فِي شَيْءٍ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, cynical word is like this, that every single issue has an emotion behind it.
It has what?
An emotion behind it. But Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, that emotion, it does not stand still.
Emotion
does not, it goes down very soon. So based on emotion, don't go further.
Yes.
Just wait a little bit. Let the emotion to go down. Then think, what should I do?
Yes.
All these adversities are coming because of what? Say, because of emotion. The moment you will become emotion, you cannot have control. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, so sometimes you say such a word because you became emotional. And later on you have to say, sorry. Yes, I'm very sorry for that. So if Rasulullah said, control your emotion. There is a hadith. A big one came to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and he said to the Messenger of Allah, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, as you know that Bidwan are very simple people. Sitting in desert, ke maqasid ki karta hai ne gahbani, ya bandai sahrai, ya marde kuhistani. Allah must say, yes, yes. These two types of people are very close to nature. Number one, those who are living on hilltops, and those who are living in desert. You understand? They are very simple people. They don't know much more munafaqat and hypocrisy.
Yes.
And what we call civilized and cultured people living in big cities, they are subhanAllah, the hypocrisy. But they know, nobody knows like that. Even shaitan doesn't know like that.
Yes.
And we call it what? Civilization. Culture.
Yes.
Am I right? I'm sorry to say that. I'm sorry to say that. But we are playing with nature even. We are playing games with nature even. Yes, we do or not?
Yes.
So, the people in desert are the people living there in mountains. They are mostly very simple people and very close to nature.
Yes, they are eating natural, drinking natural, breathing natural, dressing natural, speaking natural.
Yes. God has not it. We are artificial.
Yes,
our eating is artificial and drink is also. What do you mean by soft drink?
Artificial.
Yes or not?
Yes.
So, then this one said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَوْسِنِي بِخَيْرٍ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Can you please tell me some good? Some advices. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him three advices. Simple man, so that was to his approach. عَلَيْكَ بِلْيَاسِ عَمَّا فِي أَيْدِ النَّاسِ. Don't look into the pockets of others and to the hands of others. What a beautiful sentence. Don't look into the pockets of others and to the hands of others. You know what I'm saying? Do something on your own. While you are expecting from people, don't look into the pockets of others and to the hands of others. عَلَيْكَ بِلْيَاسِ عَمَّا فِي أَيْدِ النَّاسِ. And number two, وَإِيَّاكَ وَالتَّمْعَ فَإِنَّهُ فَقْرٌ حَاضِرٌ. Never be greedy. Otherwise, you will be poor forever. Never ever be greedy. Otherwise, even though you will be billionaire, but still you will be a poor.
Yes.
کہ گفت چشم خوار دنیا دار را یا قناعت پر کو ندیا حاکی گور. You know what I'm saying? Someone greedy, he will never become full. Billionaire, still he will be thinking for every single penny.
Yes.
And poor people like us, we don't think not for penny and not for, for dollar. Yes, we spend it. We think we'll have to borrow once again and Allah will give us some thing from somewhere.
Yes.
And rich people, they are calculating. Yeah, subhanAllah. Every single penny should be in its proper column. And number three, وَإِيَّاكَ وَالْأَمْرَ الَّذِي يُعْتَذَرُ مِنْهُ. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, try to avoid such a word or such an act for which you have to say later on, sorry. So you should have thought about that
before saying it or before doing it.
So the ayah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ سَيَجْعَلُ لَهُمُ الرَّحْمَنُ وُدًّا. Indeed, those who believe firmly and practice accordingly, سَيَجْعَلُ لَهُمُ الرَّحْمَنُ وُدًّا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create a wood for them. Wood. This is the word in Arabic. Wood. Which means love. So Allah will create a love for them amongst them. That's number one. And number two. Allah will be in love with them. And they will Allah. Allah will be in love with them, and they will be in love with Allah. If you will get into this, that is the success of this world and the hereafter. We are trying a lot, but we cannot put our car in the proper direction to go towards Allah. Yes, if we will put it on the same trailer, yes. Got it? So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be in love with us, and you will be having a satisfaction in your life. Yes, mental peace in your life. No any hassle and bustle. Calm and quiet. Yes. Stick to your own words. Not changing of your mind time and again. Stability. Istiqamah. وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. Yeah, that's because you want to carry. No, you got it? Or not? What about Hafiz Hasan? He's not? Yes, he is. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim wa ala al-Nabiyy al-Kareem Muhammadin wa alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. So yesterday we were talking about the first portion of the hadith narrated by Abu Dharr al-Ghifari radiallahu ta'ala an. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my servant, I have forbidden oppression for myself and have made it forbidden amongst you. So do not oppress one another. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, الظلم ظلمات يوم القيامة الظلم ظلمات يوم القيامة means oppression is the darkness on the day of judgment. Oppression is darkness is on the day of judgment. And what is the definition of zulm in Arabic? وضع الشيء في غير محله. To put a thing not in its proper place. As to put a thing in a wrong place. This is zulm. This is literal definition of zulm. Got it? To put a thing in a wrong place, not in its proper place. So then you can apply it. A definition? You can apply it. You know what I'm saying? Yes. to walk in front of your dead, that's a zulm. Why? Because your status is behind your dead, not in front of your dead. Got it? Or not? Yes. Not to speak nicely to your honey, that is zulm. You know what I'm saying? You have to speak nicely and very kindly, and you have to. Yes. But if you will not, that is zulm. Got it? And for a wife, not to obey her husband, that is zulm. That's oppression. So you will apply this definition every year to something means not in its proper place. You know what I'm saying? So that's called what? Zulm or oppression. The second part of hadith, Ya Ibadi, O my servant. Translation already you have written. Kullukum bu'allun illa man hadaituhu. All of you are astray except for those I have guided. Fastaduni. So seek guidance of me and I shall guide you. What is guidance? Our hidayah. Hidayah. Hidayat or hidayah. Got it? Its literal meaning is to show the path to someone. This its literal meaning. Got it? And technically, it has two applications. Number one, when you say hidayah or guidance, by Allah, guidance by Allah. So that is defined as taking a person to his destination or object. Allah's hidayah is like this, to take a person to his final destination or to his object. And hidayah by someone else, by anybody else, it means the same one showing the path towards destination. Got it? Showing the path towards destination. For Allah to take someone to his final destination, this is Allah's hidayah. Hidayah by anybody else, including Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is showing the path towards the destination. And that's why in Holy Quran, there is, yes, only for academic persons, there is a contradiction, which is not. And that is, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. But first, وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِيهِمْ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. What I said? There is Shura, ayah number?
52.
And chapter?
Chapter number 42.
Chapter 42, ayah number 52. Allah says, and indeed, you O Muhammad, write it down, the translation. And indeed, you O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you guide them towards the straight path. to the straight path. Now, straight path is not defined a destination. There's a source to take or to lead someone to his destination. You know what I'm saying? Freeway fire, that is not defined a destination. That is a source, yes, a way to take you to Sacramento or to Los Angeles, to somewhere, where are you going? To Bakersfield or as the case may be. Got it? Your destination is, for example, Sacramento or Bakersfield or San Francisco or Stockton or as the case may be. But what's the way? Freeway 5. So if somebody will tell you that, yes, take freeway north, it will take you to Sacramento. Got it? So that is Hidayah. That is because you showed him the path which will lead him ultimately to his final destination. But you cannot take him to final destination. Yes. And if somebody asks you, I want to go to Sacramento, so can you guide me? You say, yes. Just have the passenger seat. And he stayed with you. And you took the fire freeway and you took him to downtown Sacramento. This is Sacramento. Got it? So this type of Hidayah is, yes, to take him to the final destination. So regarding deen, this type of Hidayah is only by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes. But as far as the case of showing path is concerned, anybody can do that. Yes? Or not? So the second ayah, which contradicts this one, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you guide. Here he said, you guide. But here in another ayah Allah says, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَدْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءَ. Ayah number?
Ayah number 56, Surah number 28.
Surah what? Surah name?
Surah Al-Qasas.
Which is Surah number 28 and ayah number? 56. Allah says, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَدْتَ. Indeed, you cannot guide one whom you like. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءَ. But only Allah can guide one whom He wills. So look, this is an obvious contradiction between two ayahs. Yes. If you will not be studying Quran by from a sheikh, so you will be confused. If you will have this ayah, then here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, O Muhammad, you cannot guide. And there is Surah Shura, which says, O Muhammad, you guide. What's this? This is the book of Allah. Can you imagine this book of Allah, which has a contradiction? Once he said, you cannot guide. Yes. For the second time he said, you guide. You know what I'm saying? Yes. So if you do not know the proper definition of Hidayah in two ways, so you will be confused. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive and forbid. If you will think about the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the contradiction is here, you will lose your iman. Yes or not? But when you will be with faith, so he will tell you there is no contradiction. Because Hidayah has two definitions. Number one, showing a path. And that was the beauty of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was doing that. He was doing that. But taking someone to the final destination, that is not the duty of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or duty of anybody else. That is the duty of only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Muhammad did his job. Some people, they accepted their direction and they went and approached Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab. Yes. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guided them as well. But they did not accept. So they could not approach the final destination. Now you got it? So that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. That all of you are astray. Except for those I have guided. So seek guidance of me and I shall guide you. The third portion. Ya ibadi kullukum jaya. O my servants, all of you are hungry. Except for those I have fed. So seek food of me and I shall feed you. You know what I'm saying? Human being. In physical world, is bound to have his planning. Yes. To have good for him. For himself. But his belief must be that Allah has given me this. Yes? You studied. You got a job. Why you study? Running early in the morning to college or to university or to, as the case may be. Yes. Or you are doing your business. Why you are doing this? That you are planning. That's what? You are planning for your livelihood. To have your livelihood. You know what I am saying? So that you are planning. But whatever you are receiving, based on your job or business, or as the case may be, as a Muslim, your belief must be that Allah is giving me this. Otherwise, so many people, they have the same degree, but they couldn't find job. Yes? They have the same type of business, but they couldn't earn their livelihood. They are trying to get rid of their business. Got it? So it means that if the job or the business is the provider, so why it is not the same with the other guy? You know what I'm saying? For example, Hafiz Saab, he is qualified radiologist. Yes. And for example, I am as well. But Hafiz Saab, he has a job. I'm looking for, I couldn't. I have the same qualification. Yes. Planning, mine and his, both is the same. Yes or not? But he has the job. So it means that Allah provided him. I don't have. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not decided yet. God is not yet. And that's why we say that human being is bound to do his planning. Yes. And he is bound to believe in the planning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is right in back here. Human being is bound to do his planning. But he is bound to have belief in the planning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding every single thing. Things will never come according to your planning. Things will come according to the planning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, we call it taqdeer. We call it what? Yes. Predestined. Predestined. Got it or not it? So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُلُّكُمْ جَائِعٌ إِلَّا مَنَ أَطْعَمْتُهُ فَاسْتَطْعِمُونِي أُطْعِمْكُمْ. Number 4. Ya ibadi. The same thing, but another context. كُلُّكُمْ هَارٍ. Every one of you is naked. إِلَّا مَنْ كَسَوْتُهُ. Except for those I have clothed. فَاسْتَطْعِمُونِي أَكْسُكُمْ. So see clothing of me and I shall clothe you. The same thing. Number 5. O my servants, innakum tukhti'una billayli wan nahar. You sin by night and by day. Wa anaghfiru dhunuba jami'an and I forgive all sins. Fastaghfiruni aghfir lakum. So see forgiveness of me and I shall forgive you. Human by nature. Has desires. And sometimes he fulfills it. In a wrong way. This is a sin. Number one. Human or Muslim?
Instead of human,
Muslim. Is bound to obey the commandments or the commands but he does not. This is another type of thing.
Got it?
One sin is by doing. And the other sin is by not doing. You know what I said? Two types of sin. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you sin by night and by day, you sin by night and by day, and sins are of two types. Minor sins and major sins. Minor sins could be erased by doing good deeds. Minor sin could be erased by practicing good deeds. Surah Hud ar-Ra'd. وَاقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفَيِ النَّهَارِ وَزُلَفًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ ذَلِكَ ذِكْرَ لِلذَّاكِرِينَ. You got it? Find it either in Surah Hud or in Surah Ra'd. Surah. I said Surah Hud or Surah Ra'd. Salaam alaikum. Now, so where is the electric number? We will find out. We will find out. Okay. Assalamu alaikum. Inshallah. Salam alaikum. You found it? Surah Hud, chapter 11. 11, ayah number?
Ayah number 114.
وَاقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفَيِ النَّهَارِ. Perform the prayer in both sides of the day, the beginning and the end, and in the part of night. Indeed, good deeds take away the evil deeds. Good deeds take away the evil deeds. So small sins could be forgiven by your righteous good deeds. But major sins, these are of two types. Number one, due rights of Allah. And number two, due rights of human being. Due rights of Allah. Missing something? Mandatory. This is one thing. Like your first prayer, or was a prayer, or your fasting. You didn't do that. That's a sin. It was a due right of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, doing something which is forbidden. Like telling lies. That's what? That's forbidden. And that's the due right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a slave of Allah, you may not tell lies. As a slave of Allah, you may not tell lies. That's forbidden. And you did it. So that is another type of lie. Got it? As far as this case is concerned, you have to make it. Which is called qada. You have to make it. You missed it. Your prayer yesterday. So what you will do? Qada. Got it? And by making qada, or with by making qada, or along with making qada, you have to make a repentance to Allah that, oh Allah, I missed my prayer in proper time. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. Got it? And the second one, in life, you have, or you must, repent to Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if that has caused any harm to anyone, physically or financially, so automatically it will become this. Automatically it will become what? The second type, due rights of human beings. You told lies. Lies forbidden by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By telling that lie, you caused some harm to somebody. You know what I'm saying? Got it or not? So now automatically it has become the second type, which is the due right of human being. Our further detail of due rights of human being to deprive anyone of his belonging, to harm anyone physically, or in honor, you insulted him, you harmed his honor and dignity. Got it? So in first case, where you couldn't remade it, you missed some mandatory thing and you couldn't remade it. You know what I'm saying? Or you violated a rule of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which was forbidden and you did it. Which was forbidden. And you did it. So you must make repentance with full sincerity. You must make repentance with full sincerity. And that repentance is consists of three things. Number one, to blame his own self for his wrong. I have done wrong. To blame from the bottom of his heart, I have done wrong. Number two, to come out of that field of wrong where he has committed that wrong, he must come out of that field. And number three, to make a strong will not to do it again. Got it or bought it? Yes. You got it? So these are three things. But as far as the case of due rights of human being is concerned, so you should add to it to ask him to forgive you. And number five, if that is something material or financial, so repentance is to return it to him and to ask forgiveness. They are only asking for forgiveness will never work. For example, in a wrong way, I have taken away $10,000 of brother Khalid. I have not. Yes, they are going on record for that kind of thing. So you should not sue me. So anyhow, for example, I have taken $10,000 of brother Khalid. I cheated him. May Allah forgive and forget. I told some lie and I got it. You know what I'm saying? Which is a major sin. Guess what? A major sin. Now, I'm blaming myself. Why I did it? As a human being, should I have done it? No. As a Muslim, should I have done it? No. So what will I do if I am going to repent? Yes, going to Brother Khalid. Dear Brother Khalid, I am very sorry. Looking at the ground, not looking into his eyes, because you will not be having haya, because the next sentence which you are going to express, yes, you must have haya of that sentence. Then Brother Khalid, I am very sorry. Once it happened, I told some lie. And I got $10,000, which was your due right, not mine. I took it in a wrong way. So this will be $10,000. And please, for the sake of Allah, forgive me. Yes? And if you go to Brother Khalid, I have taken your $10,000, and please, for the sake of Allah, forgive me. Yes, this is the easy way. Tomorrow you should take another $10,000 of Brother Khalid Hassan, if you can. Huh? Got it? Yes, that's another thing. The Brother Khalid will say, no, I have forgiven you. That's a gift to you. Got it? That's another thing. But you can ask, Brother Khalid, it happened like this. But do you know, I don't have it. Forgive me for the sake of Allah. Who will believe you don't have it? Yes, everybody will say, I don't have it. Even the billionaires, they will never say that I have it. They say, you don't have it. Yes? Or not? Yes, this is human nature. No. This is the $10,000 which I have taken a wrong way. That's an
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me, then please, you should forgive me. And this year. And at that time, when the money is there, because when you have not taken to him any money, you say, I have taken your $10,000 and you don't know, but actually I cheated you. Yes, so please forgive me. Or I will try to give it to you, but please. No, just take it to him. This is. And please forgive me. Now he says, no, Allah has given me a lot. This is a gift for you. And that is good. God does not it. Ask. If you have harmed someone physically, just go to him. Say, at that time, yes, I was wrong. Yes, I lost temper. I pushed you, or I slapped you, or I punched you. Yes, this is not good. That's haram. But I have committed that sin, so I am here. If you want to take a revenge, or kisas, or retribution, yes, this is my fear. Got it? Or this is my back. Punch me the way I have punched you. Or forgive me for the sake of Allah. God is not it. You know what I'm saying? And if you will say, oh, I punch you at that time and said your backbone is not working properly, but please forgive me. So then what? He'll forgive you and his backbone will never work. No, this is my backbone. Yeah. Go ahead. If you want to break it, just go and break it. But forgive me for the wrongdoing which I have caused you. God is not it. So that's called Tawbatun Nasuh. Tawbatun Nasuh. That's your responsibility. You have to convince. So then you have to repay him back. He will never forgive you for free. For free, how can he forgive you? Without giving you the 10,000? No, you are not bound to forgive him. Just give me my money, then I will forgive you. That's what I say. That there is no way of forgiveness. That I will give you $10,000, please forgive me. Why I should forgive you? Have you got me your $10,000, my $10,000? Yes, this is. But you will pay him and you will ask him, forgive me, because I cheated you. This is your money, but please forgive me. For 1 hour, yes, I seized your money. For 1 year, I seized your money in a wrong way. For 10 years, I seized your money in a wrong way. And every single minute that was a sin, yes, so your money is here, but please forgive me. This is the forgiveness. Got it? So that's called Tawbatun Nasuh. Ayah number? Surah Al-Hadith or Surah Tahrim? Surah Tahrim. Alladhina amanu, tubu ila Allah. Nahi, but so what? Aapne repay kar diya, aap kar Allah se maafi mange.
Surah
66, ayah number 8. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe, tubu ilallah, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tawbatan nasuha. A repentance with a full sincerity. A repentance with full sincerity. Now if somebody to whom you have taken his money back, they take it and please forgive me. And he says, no, give me money, I'm not going to forgive you. You know what I'm saying? But you don't have any right. Okay, then you are not forgiving me, I'm taking this money back. No, just give his money to him. Now get up to him. Yeah? God said, otherwise just the easy way. Okay, you are not forgiving me. Okay, salam alaikum. Yes? See you then. God is not it. So furthermore, the next portion. وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين.